This is Bill Vansell, and it's been a long time. I was at KSTT starting in 1961, clear through 1969 when I came here to Madison, Wisconsin, where I am now the station manager and vice president for programming of WMGN and WTDY. I was the program director of KSTT during the years that you guys were in high school. Those were some great years. We had some great times with Clark Anthony and Gordon Vann and Larry Cooper and Lee Shannon and Lou Gooten Bagoo. KSTT in the mid-60s was a phenomenon that we didn't realize was happening at the time. We look back on it, and it really indeed was something special. I looked back through some of my old tapes, hoping that I could find an air check, a recording of my program, and I couldn't find one. I guess over the years I've tossed them all out, and probably for the better. I did find a clipping of tape from the Lou Gutenberger show, if you can imagine. I don't know what year it was or what, but I think it'll bring back some memories for you.
Brand new from the happenings, it's a discovery this week. Good night, my love. 51 degrees outside now. It's 26 minutes before 1 o'clock, KSTT fall fun time.
Uh-oh. Hi, Lou.
Here he is.
It's me, Dan, the salesman.
Hi, Dan. What's
up? Boy, do I have something great here.
What are you doing?
Am I use your phone?
No, go right ahead.
Calling somebody that you know.
Somebody that I know, huh?
Your agent, Sid Seesaw.
Oh, wait a minute. What are you calling
him? No, wait a minute, Lou. This is great.
Dan, what are you calling Sid Seesaw?
You just hang on.
Oh, got enough trouble here.
Hello, Seesaw Enterprises.
Oh, boy.
This is Mr. Seesaw himself speaking at you.
Hi there, Sid. This is Dan, the salesman over at KSTT.
Dan?
Dan, sweetheart. Good to hear from you.
Yeah.
You got the little jingle package I sent you?
Yeah, I got it. I don't know whether Lou is going to go for the idea or not, Sid.
Put him on the phone.
Lou, he wants to talk to you.
Yeah, I know. Sid, now wait a minute.
You want to help your sales staff out?
What is this jingle idea?
Give a listen to this.
What?
Spin it for him, Dan.
Roger.
What are you going to spin here, anyway?
Honey, baby, what a trill you his. Necktie matches and hanky matches and got no matches, that's him. Dan, the salesman, is groovy. Oh. We saw him today in the movie. His hanky matches his paisley tie. Oh,
I don't believe this.
Buy it from Danny the salesman. He's not just any guy. His hanky matches his paisley tie. Scooby-Doo.
His hanky matches his paisley tie, all right.
Well, what do you think, sweetheart?
Sid, I don't think I don't think we'd better try anything with this at all. If you don't mind, it's
Oh, you don't want to let your sales staff get a little of limelight, huh?
Well, no, it's not that. It's just
I didn't think that was possible of you, Lou, baby. I'll talk to you later.
What? Sorry.
Gee, I'm really disappointed. I never get any jingles or anything.
Dan, salesmen don't need. Forget it.
Don't remember how the rest of that jingle went, but those were indeed the good old days of radio, and we did some wild and crazy things, and I know we'll cherish those memories for a long, long time. So, this is Bill Vansell, and I have enjoyed very much being a part of your class reunion, class of 1965. Good luck to you in the future, and help us keep those memories of KSTT in that era alive forever.
Lonely, I'm Mr. Lonely. I have nobody for my own.
Hi, hello there, Alumni. Hi, this is Lou Gutenberger, formerly with KSTT Radio from 1961 to 1968, and I worked a variety of shifts. Anytime a slot opened up, they said, let's put Lou in there. So I couldn't really, most of the time I guess we could say that I was on from 6 to 10 in the morning, did a variety of things. One of the big contests that we did, now this is true, I'm not kidding about this, they had a contest, the movie was State Fair, was involved in, let's see, what was it, Blue Boy the Pig. And they had a contest, guess how many steps it will take Lou to walk across the bridge from Davenport to Rock Island to the Capitol Theater, I believe it was, carrying a pig. And we had a pig in a little box, and we carried him across They also wrapped me up like a mummy at one of the Good Guy Go-Go's. And they were supposed to guess who that was wrapped up there in all of that gauze for about an hour and a half. That was another fun thing that we did. So I know that this brings back a lot of tender memories for you. But isn't it fun to go to a reunion? 20 years, huh? Boy, I just went to one of my reunions, too, but I'm not going anymore. Isn't it funny? You go to see all your friends and instead all these old people show up. What am I doing now? Well, right now I'm working at KOH Radio in Reno, Nevada, and for about the last year and a half, I've been doing a talk show. And it certainly keeps one on his toes. Anyway, it was good to hear from you. We hope that your class reunion turns out to be really super. So for now, from Reno, this is Lou Gutenberger saying bye-bye.
This is KSTT.
Oh, the memory of it all. Hi, I'm Clark Anthony, one of the KSTT good guys in the mid-60s. Or as we used to like to say back then...
Good guy!
Clark Anthony!
See, we had our very own KSTT cheerleaders, of course, which made it nice for me because I was in high school back then, just like you were, and I couldn't seem to get our high school cheerleaders to even look at me, much less speak to me, much less shout my name out.
Good guy!
Clark Anthony!
So that was a real charge. My main claim to fame, in addition to having met Andy Casillas one time in person, but other than that, my main claim to fame was that I worked in the very same radio studio with Lou Gutenberger. Now, I haven't seen Lou for years, but I continue to use some of the funny material that I stole from him, just as everybody else does who ever worked with Lou. Today I live in San Diego, and I work at KFMB Radio and Channel 8 Television. It's the CBS affiliate here in town. I'm on the radio middays from 10 to 2, and I'm the television weatherman at 5 and 11 o'clock at night, Monday through Friday. Now, San Diego is just like it looks on Simon & Simon, except we have fewer car chases normally. So how are things in the Quint Cities? Or did you ever drop one city and become the Quad Cities again? Or did you finally add another city and become the Sex Cities? I have a lot of great memories of the Quad Quint Cities, and especially of KSTT. In fact, you know, I even remember the KSTT Good Guys basketball team.
Down the left side comes Bob Henry. Henry feeds to Vansell between the rings. Bounce pass to Cooper. Cooper gives to Gutenberger behind the screen. 20-foot jump shot off the side. No good. Rebound by Anthony is blocked. Anthony has it. Hook shot is good. Anthony scores.
Oh, I was always a lot better on the radio than I ever was in person. I still consider the Quad City area to be my hometown. My parents still live back there. In fact, I just missed my Rocky High School Class of 65 reunion a couple of weeks ago. Couldn't make it back. But by coincidence, I actually am in town this weekend, somewhere. I'm not sure where, since this message was recorded earlier for broadcast in this time zone. Well, listen, if I see you or you see me, we should say hello. Or, as we say in California, we should do lunch sometime. You wear your school jacket, so I recognize you now, you hear? And you'll know it's me, of course, because I still travel with the cheerleaders.
Good guy!
Clark Anthony!
Yeah, they're getting older, but it's still an ego boost. Listen, congratulations on your 20th, and have a super weekend.
This is KSTT.
This is KSTT.
Quint City.
When some loud bragger tries to put me down and says his school is great, I tell him right away, now what's the matter, buddy? Ain't you heard of my school? It's number one.